what I'm going to do is I'll give you a rough outline on how to make them, what trees to use. You can use any tree except a pine tree to make a bow. Okay? Anything works on making bows. Now what I'll do is I'll start off, okay, let's start off with this, what I use. You see that tree over there in front of the shed? That one that comes up 3 points, you see how crooked it is? It's hard to find a good straight piece off of that tree, but that's what I use. It's a good skill. Now I'll cut a piece like this on.
I'll
trim all the bark off of it.
Awesome,
put it down in the spot wood, that sapwood. Once I get past that sapwood, wood underneath it, it's yellow. Okay? We call it cupweed. That's how you say it with Cherokee. You say it?
No.
You say cupweed. The long gate. Yeah. Anyway, once I get down there, now I'm going to follow one growth ring all the way down the entire length. You know how to tell the age on a tree by the
bow demonstration.
Okay, now what I do is I follow one ring all the way down it all the way across. That keeps it from breaking. Now, once I've done that, then I'll draw the bow out. You see them pencil lines I put on there? Okay, that's my bow. I drew those on there so y'all get an idea of what I see. That is the bow, okay? For the pencil lines inside the pencil lines, that's the bow itself. Now, once I shave all that down, then I'm going to start shaving the back of it, or the belly of it right here, and making it bend. And all I'm doing really is taking it and bending on it like this and lifting at it and looking for stiff spots. Anywhere there's a stiff spot, shave a little bit of it off until it starts to bend. You want this bow to bend right here to right there. Utilize as much of that piece of wood as you can. You don't have to worry about little crooks like this. Okay, you know how to make them, you don't have to worry about knots. Okay, to me, that's just characters and they're crooked and they got knots in them. Now, once you're finished making it, you rub the entire thing down with bear fat. Okay? The strings we used on our bows back then were made out of a bear's intestine. Okay?
Your digestive food.
The arrows we used back then were nothing but this is river cane. Let me find him. This one.
Bamboo?
River cane. It's in the same family, but it's different. They're kin to each other, put it that way. Okay. Now I'll just take a piece of river cane, go down the river, give you a piece of river cane, let it dry out. Once it dries out, then I'll heat it and bend it to straighten it out. Okay? And they don't have to be perfectly straight. Then the nodes, I'll take them and grind them down until it's smooth like this. Okay, that way it doesn't affect you when it goes over your hand. Now, to tie feathers on, what I'm going to use is wild turkey feathers and sinew. Okay, call it uwadun. It's ligaments. You know what a ligament is? You know what tendons are?
No.
You know that little piece right here on the back of your foot?
Yeah.
Okay. We use these off of deer. And they're wide and thick, and if you just kind of mess with them, you'll get pieces like this. We used to sew with this stuff too, it's real strong. Now what I'll do is I'll take it, tear a piece off like this, and I'll chew on it. And once I've got my feathers, there he is. While it's still wet after I've chewed on it, I'll take it and start tying it like this, okay? And that's how I tie my hair. For arrowheads, I use the same stuff. And this stuff is like rawhide. When you chew on it, it's soft and moist. You tie it on, when it dries, it starts to shrink. Really aggressive.
And it gets real hard.
Now, let's do a little shooting. We'll shoot these two first, I guess. Really don't matter which one you shoot. Now, I don't actually aim, not when I'm doing stuff like this. What they were doing, what I do, is I just pull it back and let go. It's like throwing a rock. I know what I want to hit. You know what I mean? I know what I want to hit.
Joseph!
A little bit low.
I found Joseph.
Oh, yeah, I found one.
Low on that one. I probably hit left again on this one like I did that other one. on that one. Trying to be resistant.